राधे जय जय माधव दई राधे।
Yes, sometimes see you should talk.
Yes.
How you are doing? How we are doing?
Yes, I'm okay. And I'll be in touch with all the Prabhus, also Vodar and Vrajana, to help more and be more involved.
Okay.
Yes.
Improving Krishna consciousness. And you are studying more?
Yeah.
Very good.
All the flowers have come in bloom. You have come here. The weather got nice and all the flowers have come in. So the Lord is giving you so much.
Come on.
Martin Dale's house.
Yeah.
Okay.
You can.
Yeah, I will go and help her.
You can also come to Hawaii.
Yes, you should come.
I want to come.
No, Gurudev's business is.
He won't let me.
Oh, but no harm if you are not. I'm taking care of my business.
Okay.
Because then if it's out, then you have to run out.
Gurudev? If we cannot bring the picture of Parm Gurudev this time, picture of Parm Gurudev,
no,
I can bring it part, you can
yeah. Oh, okay. Very good. All pictures, no.
You can also the make ones for Durvastina.
You will make some photographs also.
This energy, I want.
Yes. We are liking you to come here, the new Braja.
Come here and you can give yourself in
time. If you would just say specifically which place, then I would go there.
Does anyone say maybe here? We are trying to make
a decision.
Anywhere. We are making preachings. I want to make you head of
Yes.
You are qualified to go.
England.
But in England you have some problems. So, yeah. Like, RPO. Actually, let me see. When I will call, I have to come at once without a millisecond.
American Express. No.
Very good. Man, if any will do pranam, then I will do more.
Kalyanam bhavat.
Kalyanam bhavat. Kalyanam bhavat. Kalyanam bhavat. Oh, you played the role yesterday?
Yes.
Of Vishnu Priya. Oh, Kalyanam bhavat.
I wanted to ask you a question. This year, we have so many rattlesnakes because of the grass is very tall. And when we find them, should we kill them?
No.
They're poisonous Temple. Snakes?
Snake.
Anywhere.
Just anywhere around our homes.
Sometimes the rattlesnakes
the kids
come.
And stuff.
Oh, then you should clear.
Clear.
And just take them away.
Yeah. Go on.
Even the karmis.
Don't try to kill them, but you can take them in. Snakes?
Poisonous snakes. Just take them away, don't kill them.
Try. And if necessary, you can go no.
They attack.
Necessary. Because they are very hard.
Even the karmi
says.
Yeah, but there's no need to kill. There's no need. They don't. They won't.
When all the bodies left,
a few times though, like we got them,
they went on the hill.
Take them away, and they come back, and they've killed my rabbits.
And they were eating.
It's so beneficial. Maybe I'll become your peacock.
Very good.
I don't know what kind of peacock, but some kind.
Rare.
Whatever he likes, I'll become.
Srimati Radhika Nam is written here. That is why Krishna keeps here.
Yes. I see.
Oh, yeah.
Remind me to tell you this Prabhupada story about Pika.
I should help you with this.
Yes.
Chaturunmilitam jena tasmai sri gurave vancha kalpatarubhyasya kripa sindhubhyaye vacha patitanam bhavanebhyo vaishnavebhyo namo mahavadanaya krishna prema paraya krishna namne gaurat Gurave Gaurachandraya Radhikaya Tadaya Krishnaya Krishnabhaktaya Tadabhaktaya Namo Yang Prabhrajantam Anupetam Apetakrityam Dvaipayano Virahakataraya Juhava Putreti Tanmayataya Tarobhi Tam Sarvabhutaridayam Tavai vasmi, tavai vasmi, na jivani, tadina, iti deha, radhe, tamne, maam. Now you should be ready to come with me to fly India. And then at once come with me in Vrindavan. From Vrindavan we are going now to Gokul. Where Gokul? In the palace of Nanda Baba and Yashoda. And you can see with me there. Krishna is taking breath of his mother. I am Yashoda Devi, giving her breast milk to his Lala Kanhaiya. There is a competition. Krishna is too much hungry. Yashoda Bhaiya has so much milk, more than Birja or Khir Sagar or anything. So there is not chance, any chance, that this ocean of milk will dry. And there is no chance that Krishna's stomach will be fulfilled. Never. But in the meantime, there was a milk pot on fire, and the milk was overflowing. It got all down it. Yashoda, very good, very good. Mother Yashoda, for that. Milk is overflowing. And it was falling on fire. Yashoda became very merciful. She thought that that milk on this pot is thinking, because they are all transcendental. Oh, he is thinking that I am not going to be accepted by Krishna. I am so unqualified. And Krishna is engaged in taking the milk, best milk of my mother Yashoda. And I will always be neglected. So if I am not doing serving Krishna, what is the use of keeping milk? So all devotees should think, and really the devotees, they think that if I am not serving my Gurudev, why I'm going to serve my Gurudev? Only to have to serve Krishna, Kanjuga, or Mahaprabhu, or Nityananda. But this is not served, we cannot hope less than no use of keeping life. We should try to serve Radha Krishna, Kanjuga. But if we cannot do, then no use of life. That is why Narottam Thakur is telling ki keno va achaye pran ki sukh lagiya. Why my pran is here, my life is here, why not coming out? I don't want to keep my life for a moment because I'm not serving Krishna and Radha. I'm not being qualified, so I should die. So that milk was thinking that I should die burning in fire. So but it was coming. Yashoda Maiya, like a guru, she thought that I should go and at once I should save his life. So to give a chance for that milk or any devotees, guru sometimes leaving the service of Krishna himself and comes down and they help devotee that I'm giving chance you to serve Krishna. You should serve Krishna first and then I will serve. So Gurudev is so merciful. Yashoda Maiya. So and at once she wanted that I should running away, go there and save that devotee. But Krishna was taking milk. When he saw that Yashoda Maiya wants to keep me from her lap to down on earth, oh, she became like monkey boy. And he catch hold very tightly here, there, with legs, with mouth very tightly, and with hands so tightly, with legs like monkey, you know. Have you seen Indian monkey? Very expert. So Krishna, he was not satisfied, so he wanted to take more milk. But now he has tightened her mother. But mother was so in hurry, so with one hand, very easily, you should sit here. And Krishna was controlled and he sat there. But he was so angry. You know that Putna was so powerful, having the power of 50,000 elephant, not horses. 3 horsepower, 4 horsepower, not elephant. 50,000 elephant power. An elephant has perhaps how much? With so many horses he can do like this and so much power. And Krishna easily was shocking her breasts. No use power. But she could not get rid of Krishna. And here Yashoda, Krishna engaged his all power, six kinds of opulence there, so much power. Being supreme personality of Godhead, supreme personality of all powers. But she cannot do so. Easily Yashoda kept him. Oh, sit down here. And she ran. And Krishna was thinking that, oh, Yashoda has so much prem for, love for, Milka, not to me. And he wanted to cry and weep, but now he has some anger. And so first he wanted to do something and then weep. So he wanted to turn over that pot with all curd and everything. He wanted, but he was so weak that he could not do anything. Then he searched any other way. There was a stone there. Indian ladies, they use in masala. Very little. And his thought was so clever and tricky that upper part so much thicker and lower part so much thin. And if I will break it on the top, all liquid will not go away. So all liquids will go away because mother has left me. And that is why he took that stone and made a hole in the bottom very easily. And then when liquid was coming, white, then he was looking that, oh, how will it come, everywhere, the spray. After that, he has this thing that he became fear. He had a fear that, oh, mother will come and see and chastise me. Not only chastise. No? What she will do? So, he discovered a way. He saw there is the room. Having two gates. One coming to courtyard and one to go out of courtyard or home, outside on the roadside. And quickly he entered there. And there were so many
hanging ropes,
water pots hanging. And there was a motor, grinder motor there was. And he climbed up there and very easily used to take from all others. Sometimes taking himself and sometimes giving to monkeys. Why to monkeys? Because monkeys in Treta Yuga, they have served Ram, that is Krishna, with their life and soul. Not wanting anything in return that, oh Ram, you should supply us some fruits or anything. Nothing. And giving their life in battle. So, Krishna thought that, I have not repaid anything. So now he is in this, and he was giving butter to her. And also some crow came, and he was distributing to, why? Because there was a Kagbhushundi in the shape of crow, a very high class of Ram devotee, always remembering him, always preaching his whole world. So he wanted to also do something for their generations. So he was distributing. When Yashoda went there, he consoled how with some water taking his hand, sprinkled like this. Oh, don't give don't worry, and don't give your life. I have come to save you. First, I will give you
chance
to serve Krishna, and then I will serve. So Guru died like this, very merciful. After that fancy return, when it came down, she took off that pot from fire, kept anywhere else, and he quickly returned. When he went there, he saw that, oh, where is boy? Where is Krishna? She began to search. At once he saw that all the liquid has come out of this, and he began to laugh. You see, very tricky, naughty. I will give a very good lesson to him. But Krishna was not there. Any thief wants to, does not want, he never keeps any
sign
of that he is same person, so that he may not be caught. Understand? What I am want to do?
Never leaves any evidence so that people will catch him.
But anyhow, he leaves some That is like police comes and they catch hold. By their dogs or by anything. By food friend, by anything. So Krishna has kept there his footprints. At that time he had not think that these footprints will help Mother Yashoda to chastise me. So now Yashoda, with this clue, he knew that Krishna had entered in this room. And quickly she took a
cane
and tipped like this. Oh, where is Krishna? He saw that he is standing on a mortar,
grinding mortar,
and taking butter from there and dividing in all monkeys. But he was also looking that like this towards door, that if mother will come, I will at once fly. Yashoda Maiya saw that he is now giving. So quickly, like a black cat, like this. You know that if there are so many dry leaves, and cat will go, walk, but no sound, very. So Yashoda Maiya like this, entered in the room, and in the shade of any kavat,
door.
And she was taking him, thinking to have any chance to
catch him.
But when he was so near and about to catch, in the meantime, monkeys began to run and crows also like this, going. Then Krishna, why they are running? At once he saw that mother with his stick is coming. And he is about to
catch.
At once he jumped up from there. And running on the road he began to run. Yashoda Maiya told, anywhere in the world you go, I must catch you and chastise you. Krishna thought that mother will not come and just follow me, because Indian ladies, they have so much shame to go out. And if any how they have anything to go out, they will take their bells like this. So with bells they cannot run. Yashoda Maiya told that you have come from my home, I am more intelligent than you. Today there are now no one here in village. All have gone to cowherd. So today is so free, I will run. But Yashoda Maiya was some healthy, very tight here, very. If anyone see here, And if she is bending, anyone can think that, oh, she should not break here. Very beautiful, very soft. But today, he took his bell here and began to run. And Krishna quickly began to run. You should know that any Mahajogi like Sukadeva Goswami or Narada even, high class of yogis, they are all, heart is so pure, but they cannot in their trance take the son of Krishna, lotus feet. They cannot touch. But Yashoda Maiya, in this body also, being a gopi, and he began to quickly run. If anyone is running and I want to catch him, then I will have to run more than that person that to whom we can catch him. So Yashoda was running more than Krishna. What is the meaning? Krishna loves his devotees. But if anyone wants to control Krishna, he will have to love Krishna more than Krishna loves you. Understand? Krishna has so much love and affection for us, but say devotees has much more love and affection than Krishna has to us. Then he can control. That is why Srimati Radhika has how much more love and affection that Krishna has to Radhika. Radhika has much more affection to Krishna than Krishna has to Srimati Radhika. And that is why Krishna always controlled by Srimati Radhika. So if anyone wants to control, he will have to love Krishna more. Yashoda has also more affection. She was running quickly. But being some sthool, healthy, and Krishna now not so much bigger, but quickly running and from this to that zigzag way, that Yashoda wanted to, oh, I have to catch hold, but at once he needs to go there. She could not catch hold. Now he was somewhat taking so long breaths. Then he searched a way that the stick which has she has, oh Krishna, see, I'm giving up, throwing. So Krishna did like that and he stood up. Mother, don't beat me. That's what I told you. Why? Yes, sir. I have done no offense. Oh, you have done no offense. Why you broke the pot? Krishna told that, I have not broken that pot. Who has broken? You, mother, you have done. How? When you are quickly running to save the milk, in your legs you have so much of golden, very powerful. Answer. Anyhow, it was stuck and it was. I have not. Oh, you are liar. No, mother. And no liar or other thief. It may be in your dynasty. Anyone was thief. But in our Baba dynasty, no one is thief, no one is liar. Then he began to laugh. And again he quickly ran. Krishna again began to run. And one after all, the flowers from his hair going on,
falling down.
At that time, as if the flowers are telling, mother, you are not alone, we are also helping you and running with you. So you should try more. Krishna is now taking so long breath. I see that we will help you, so run quickly. We are also running. understand this, that flowers one by one coming, it seems that they are also running. So Yashoda quickly took any
stone
and he did like, oh, see, at once, and from behind she catch hold of Krishna. Now he took a stick in his right hand and left hand, taking the right hand of Krishna and wanted to beat him. And Krishna was hiding himself here in the back of Yashoda and weeping, "Don't beat me, mother, don't beat me." Very, in a long, long breath. At last Yashoda Maiya becomes a merciful. "I will not beat you, but I will bind you in the same motor. You are both guilty, helping each other. So we must punish you both." And then he took to that his courtyard and tried to bind him. He took one of his rope and tried to bind him. This rope was so long, more than 2-3 yards. And Krishna, this rest, waist, was so like 12 manly fingers. And golden chain was here, with tinkling. But this rope could not go one round even. Then Yashoda Maiya is thinking that how it became. In the meantime, there came so many sakhis of Yashoda Maiya, and they saw that Krishna is so loudly weeping and doing like this, and Ganga and Jamuna are flowing from his eyes, and he khub lamba lamba he was taking so long. And so frightened, they all requested Yashoda Maiya, "Sakhi, give us, don't beat Krishna. In your old days, he has come from your home. You should be merciful to this boy. So, usko chhodo de, mane, give up." But Yashoda Maiya told that, "You should bring more ropes." And they were laughing and saying that Yashoda cannot bind him, because Brahma, the creator, has not written in his Krishna forehead that anyone can bind Krishna. But they were looking and
clapping
and laughing. What Yashoda does? So many ropes, not only so many ropes, from neighbor houses, so many ropes were come. And they were tightened together. It became so long, but they could not one round even 2 fingers less. Why? Krishna is supreme personality of Godhead, you know. So he wished that Mother Yashoda should not bind me. If she is binding, I cannot play with boys. They are standing there, Madhumangal, Subal and Sridham and all others. I cannot. So Mother Yashoda should not bind me. Oh, my very dear, beloved, also gopis, my friends are waiting for me. Cows are waiting for me. If I am not going there, they will not give milk. When Krishna will go there, automatically they will give milk. Otherwise, their calf will not make the cause of milking. They will not give to their children also, they will kick them. But when Krishna will go and seeing Krishna, they will give milk from their ass. So how I can do all these things? So, Krishna wanted that Yashoda Maya should have gone. At once, Jogmaya, the servant of, made servant of Krishna. At once, came. But anyone, if she was invisible, anyone could not see. That Krishna is not knowing anything, he is like, what?
Innocent boy.
And he is not remembering that I am Supreme Personality of Godhead and I have so much power. But Jogmaya at once came and did miracle that Krishna vestige like same and all ropes together going so long but not rounding one even. Two angles. On each round, when she tried, only two rounds, not three, not one, not a four, or so much, only two rounds. What is this? This is the thing, that if any devotee, purely following Uttama Bhakti, like Anna Vilasita Sunyam, Gyan Karma Dhanabritam Ankulena Krishna Nushilanam. He is practicing so much. Shamanam Kirtanam Vishnu Shmanam Padusivanam Archanam Bandhanam. Like giving up everything in renounce order, even like Narada and Sukadeva Goswami, like Shankar or others. But by doing so, anyone cannot control Krishna. Krishna should be merciful. Krishna is always merciful to us. So if there are no two things, if we are thinking that Krishna is so merciful, I should not do anything. Krishna is merciful, so he will sprinkle mercy. Come and miss. Like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went to door, not devotees came to Mahaprabhu. So it may be like so. Then you will have not, you cannot control Krishna. And if you are only exercising, in devouring, practicing bhakti yoga, and lakhs births, you cannot have a darshan of Krishna. Both things be there. In Krishna power, I think that supreme power is bhakta-vatsalya. What bhakta-vatsalya?
Favor of the devotees.
If any devotees is practicing so hard, not taking anything, quite fasting, always weeping, and if Krishna is merciful to them, realizing their kashta, sufferings, he becomes so soft, his heart melts, and quickly he gives darshan. But only we are doing like Yashoda, whole day, from morning till midday, practicing so much, he could not find it. So any devotee, by practicing Krishna, even pure bhakti, we cannot have darshan of Krishna. But when our practice plus Krishna mercy are together, at once quickly he will be controlled and he will be seen. So, we should try to follow Rupa Sanatana, always practicing Bhakti Yoga so hard. If anyone following Ekadashi, like we follow now, eating, drinking whole day, always our mouth is running, what? Always, this thing, another thing, something, that thing, whole day and night. Will Krishna be merciful there? No. Oh, he is happy. He is taking and he is happy. But anyone not taking anything, no sleeping night for 3 days, nothing taking, always weeping, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. In Vrindavan, in a very solitary place also. And Krishna mercy will come. That way he has not taken anything. If you chastise your boy and your boy began to weep and rolling down, then mother will give up all things and he will come and satisfy that boy. So like this. So we should not depend on our practices of bhakti yoga. But also on the other hand, without this you cannot have the mercy. So both things should be there. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has given an example for this. Marjaranyaya and Markatnyaya. Means like monkeys and like cats. When any monkey with his child wants to jump from one tree to another, the children of monkey at once jumps on the back of mother, or here, the stomach, or here. Mother has not to do anything, she will jump. But this, if the child anyhow fall down, then mother never takes again like a son and gives up that boy forever. But generally it is not so. So mother is not doing anything, but mercy is there that he should go on his back or his leg and she will jump from one place to another. So a devotee should always practicing so much. In one, and like cat has nothing to do,
kitchen,
nothing to do. They will do only meow meow, and his mother, mother will come and take in his mouth and take one place to another. In Ramana Sampradaya there are two kinds of Vaishnava like this. They depend on Krishna and one on their practicing. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu try to mix both. And then easily Krishna will be controlled. So we should do practices so much, pure practices, continuous. But also weeping for mercy. And then mercy will come and we will easily control Krishna. He gave an example more. A person fell down in a well. And he was trying himself to come out, but he could not. He was trying so much. In the meantime, any person came and he threw out a rope. See, if that person who is falling down on the well, he will take it and then he can pull. But if he is not taking tightening, then how, what he can do? So Krishna is like pulling. But if you are not holding off, then we cannot have that power or darshan of Krishna. When Krishna saw that Yashoda mother is praying Krishna, God, Narayan, this boy has come from my womb, and from very beginning in morning and up to midday, I am trying to bind him. But I could not do it. So she was like weeping, tears were coming. Face is like a reddish face. And she became so worried. He was about to weep. Sakis were saying this, his face. and Krishna also saw. At once, he became so merciful. And Kripyasi Sabandane Tishpa Parishramam Krishna. Krishna saw how hard labor is doing my mother to tighten him. And his eyes are so sweats are coming from here and there. At once Krishna became merciful, and only one rope was sufficient for binding Krishna. In half, she binded Krishna, and half, she binded Gokul. But in what way? He tightened that rope from here, from the side of his stomach. And in the end here, he gave one knot, and again, she tightened that bridle water. And he gave back tightened knots there. Krishna was weeping though, so many boys were coming. Yashoda told that, look after this boy. And anything is done, at once tell me. And she quickly went to do his householder jobs or to church. But his mind was there. Though by bodily he went, she went there. But always thinking that, how my boy? Why I did so? I have done wrong. But there was no way chastising herself. No. And here Krishna, with all the boys, first he was weeping when Yashoda mother went away. At the same time, Baldev returned from the house of Upananda with his mother. His mother went inside to see, look after Yashoda, and Baldev came directly to the council of Krishna, all friends and Krishna. And he looked at Krishna was weeping, and there were some signs like kajal and water here, and he saw that Krishna is bended. Who did it? And he became very furious. Who did it? He wanted to know. But Madhvangal came and told in his ear, Mother Yashoda. Then he was also frightened. He was so furious, he wanted to say, who has bended? If not Yashoda, then he could do anything. Or he has untied it. But then he became, oh, there must be something. And then all the boys were clapping, oh, Sri Krishna.
Today get a good lesson.
So they were clapping and laughing, and Krishna also began to laugh. Now his weeping was and playing with the boys. At once, Madhumangal has a proposal, gave a proposal, that we should try to. So Madhumangal first went. In the meantime, Subal told, I will do. Sridham told, I will do. All well, fighting within them. Who will do? But anyone could not do. At last, they proposed that Krishna should himself. He wanted to do, but his hands not so sufficient to reach that knot. He couldn't. At last, Krishna gave a proposal, because he reminded that Narada has given scarf to Nalkurva and Marikur. There are so false ego, taking birth in very high family, rich family in the world, richest family in the whole world, Kuwait. And so were very pitiful in the world, very learned also. So all these things were in them. So false ego was also there. They were playing in a pond with naked some ladies, Ashpara. Narada was going, walking. He saw that, oh, they are like a tree. They have no sense, no shame, nothing more than a tree. But the ladies at once quickly came out of the water and they covered with cloths, and from there they began to do pranam to Narvish. But these two drunkards and no shame having, they were abusing them. Why you went there? And why this old gentleman came? So he was also doing something like, and he was calling all. Nar told that you have become like a tree. You are my friend's son. Kuber was his friend, because Narada Rishi always used to go to Shankar, and this Kuber was shishya, disciple of Shankar. So they were friends. So he became so merciful to these boys and told, oh, I'll make you so pure. Go at once and be like a tree for some days, some years. At once, you see. And telling this, they became to be like a tree, and then realized, oh, Narada is so powerful. He has told, and at once we are going to be a tree. At once they quickly run and they fell on the Lord's feet of Narada. Save us, save us. Be kind to us. We have done so much offenses in your lotus feet. Now we are repenting and realizing. Narada told that I wanted, that you should realize. Now I am giving chance to you that you will be tree surely, because I have told like so. But we will be tree in Gokul. And after some lakhs years, some years means lakhs. And you will be tree there, waiting for Krishna. And when in the last of Dwapar Yug, Krishna will appear there, then mercifully he will remind you. And quickly he will touch you anyhow, and you will be liberated. And you then you will have bhakti. Satyuga. He gave this course to them in Satyuga. And after two yugas, and then they were waiting, like doing tapasya.
Austerity.
Their arms are branches like this. Can you be one day like doing so? Very hard. And someone cutting their here, there, taking their barks, because the tree is very famous for their barks and their juice. Anyone, anywhere, broken this. Then at once anyone can take, and they were so very powerful. So thousand and lakhs years they were waiting for Krishna. At last, in Dwapar Yug, this Krishna remembered this, and he wanted to fulfill the desire of his devotee. The devotee Narad desire that Krishna will liberate you. So Krishna told that we should go to play outside of this courtyard, and thus all began to do like this, to push, and Krishna also fully went to pull. Quickly they came to the gate, and very near to gate they truly were there. Very narrow gate. Krishna came out of the trees on this side, and the brindle water was in this side. Krishna had not touched the trees, but this rope touched the brindle, and rope touched the Krishna one side, and another side brindle, and brindle touched the true tree. At once, what? A current came from Krishna. Through rope, it went to mortar. And from mortar, children at once with a very great sound. Why this sound has come? All began to research. And they quickly, all Nanda Baba, Yashoda, Upananda, whole Brajavasi assembled there to see what happened. They said, they came at once and they saw that Krishna is there. So many friends are there and trees were not
falling straight.
Otherwise all the boys had been speaking. They went like this and this. Nanda Baba come running from Brahmapandita. And when Krishna saw that my father is coming, he began to again be very loudly, very Baba, Baba, like this. And tears coming so much, doing like this, breathing like so. So now Yashoda also came and from a distance he was seeing that Nanda Baba is there and all Brajavasi are there, older persons. And Shindesi was so frightened and ashamed that due to me it has been done like so. And if in this stage Krishna has died, then what to do? So Yashoda was so nervous that his all tears were dry and she became like good and she. Nanda Baba came at once to Krishna in his lap and told, who has done this? Who has banded you? Repeatedly he asked. But Krishna only weeping, not answering. Anyhow, when Baba repeated this, I said, who has done this? I will punish. Krishna told in his ear very silently that mother, mother, he became so angry. I have never seen her so cruel. Now today he has been so cruel. For only a little butter or anything. Then quickly he untied. Now Krishna somewhat pacified. And then Baba took off one good dhani means laddu and gave to Krishna. But Krishna not eating, only going to sleep. Then he told that we should go to take bath. He took Baldev Prabhu here and Krishna here. And went very grave, not speaking a word to anyone. He took bath and he met Krishna, rubbed all these things, kajal and everything, and then again took him. Now it was about 6 in evening, and he went to his home. Rukmini Devi, Rohini, and all other took Yashoda Maiya from there. She was not in a stage to walk, but by the help, she came in his room and weeping bitterly. Today, no preparation, no bhog to Thakurji, nothing, all were waiting. Yashoda Maiya. And Nanda Baba not telling any word, very great. He gave Krishna and Baldev the milk of cows. With Mishri. Mishri, you know? And thus their stomach was fulfilled. And he was sitting in the council. Mother Rohini and all were so worried for Yashoda Maiya that she will die if Krishna is not coming alive. So they took Baldev and told Baldev, and they came to Nanda Baba and Krishna and told that at once you should go and
pull him.
So, because Rohini Maiya or other ladies cannot touch Krishna in the lap of Nanda Baba. And he was so brave, so they were standing somewhat nearer but not so much near. Well, they went and tried to do like him and to call. But Krishna was so strong today that he did like this, and Krishna Baldev Prabhu fell down on the earth. And he was now looking, oh, he is more stronger than me today. Then all the ladies came no more nearer. They told to Krishna, come on, your mother is dead. I will never come. Where you will sleep? I will sleep with Baba. To whom you will play? I will play with Dau Bhaiya and father. What you will take? Oh, but father will give me milk and sugar cane from the home of so many cows. Will you not come? Your mother is so busy. No, I will not. Like, no, no. But at once Rohini told that if your mother will die, oh, then at once Krishna began to be so loudly, mother, mother, mother. And he did like that from the lap of at once Rohini came and took in his lap. Nanda Baba also was weeping so much. All were weeping. Baldeva also. And weeping, Rohini Maiya took Krishna. And up till now, Yashoda was not weeping. He had become like a stone. But when Rohini Devi gave Krishna in the lap of Yashoda Maiya, now he began to weep loud. Krishna was also all there weeping. This Rohini Maiya quickly went to the kitchen room and he was began to cook something. And thus Yashoda Maiya took Krishna in her lap and did like covered and gave his blush. After that cooking was done. And she requested all to take some prasadam offered first to Thakurji, and then Nand Baba came with Ubanand and all other senior brothers and junior brothers, and they began to take. Nand Baba took Krishna on his lap, and after that he gave Krishna and Baldev, and also all their taking. But when their taking was finished, then he also called Yashoda. Oh, you can come and take prasadam. But she was only weeping. Then Nanda Baba told in his Krishna ear that, oh, no, your mother. And Krishna, running, he went to her mother and catch hold of his well, and began to push and drag Yashoda Maiya. Anyhow, after that, Rohini also helped, all the sakhis helped Yashoda. Anyhow, Yashoda came, and then she took also remnant of all, and all were now helping. Krishna took, Yashoda Maiya took Krishna in his lap and went to sleep in a room because it was night. Gaur Brahma. So we should see, only your practice will not do. If a love and affection like Mother Yashoda, like gopis, like friend, will come. But how it will come? Only by the mercy of Krishna, by the mercy of any so highest class of devotee, plus our efforts or sadhana. But not sadhana that we are doing, it will not go. How it will do? I am telling a very little story. There was a devotee. He was doing Sravanam Kirtanam Vishnu Smaranam Pad Sevan. Also, observing all the rules and regulations of bhakti. He was detached to worldly things and he was a shade of tamarind tree. You know tamarind tree? The leaves very
small size.
And tree so big. They prefer leaves. So he was doing tapasya, I mean,
austerity.
Sometimes in trance, sometimes here and there. Very hardly. Fasting so many days. Doing this. Once Narada came. When Narada came, he did pranam, shastang pranam, and told, "Oh Rishi, where you are going? Oh, I am going to Vaikunth. Why you are going? I am going to see Narayan and to please him and to have some benediction. Can you tell my one request to Narayan?" "Yes, I can do. What is your request?" He told that. "Only you should ask Narayan. A devotee is from 1,000 years, is making so much austerities, and chanting your name and everything. So when a day will come that he will have your darshan." Narada went in Vaikunth, and after he talked with Narayan, also he requested that a devotee is in the way, meet me. And he has asked, "Oh," Narayan told, "I know." "Then when will you give darshan to that devotee?" He thought something and then told, "Go and tell to this devotee that there are leaves in tamarind tree. Count one by one, all leaves, uncountable. But anyhow, they can't be counted. So as there are leaves in that, so many births after that, you will have my darshan." Narada was unhappy somewhat by this answer of Vaikunth. And he was returning, but not that very way. He was passing by another way, but that devotee was waiting for him. So when he saw that Narada is going by that way, "Oh, Narada Rishi, come on, come on, come on, I want to have my answer. Have you asked?" Narada came returned and told, "Yes, I did question to Narada." He was very eager to hear what answer, but Narada was feeling some shame to tell. But anyhow, when he repeated to know, then he told that, "Oh, in this tree there are so many leaves. I think that if anyone count in that very birth, so much births, after that you can have darshan." Oh, hearing this, he began to overjoyed and jump. "Oh, now I have no hope that I will have darshan of Narayan. But now I have hope that surely I will have darshan after so many births. In unlimited time, but now I have come in limited time. That after these years are passed, I will surely have the darshan." So he began to dance, "Oh Hari Sri Hari, Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol." That Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol,
Hari Bol.
And at the same time, at once, Narayan came on Garuda and he gave darshan. And Narayan told, "You are lawyer? Why you told like this? Then how I will show my face to others? You told me another thing and you just came." He told that as he was doing practices for bhakti, it was not sufficient. He was not observed, always weeping and observing. And now he has forgotten everything, quietly observed, dancing and taking them, Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol. I could not remain. And that is why I am Change
it.
Uske tarah bond. I have bond to come. So I think our practices are not like so. So it may take, you will have darshan, but no guarantee that fail. It may take lakhs and lakhs births, koti births, koti births. But when we will come, there is hope. What hope? If you will do like Raghunath Das, not like Raghunatha, no heart. But if you will take shelter in the lotus feet of Raghunath Das Goswami, Rup Goswami, Sat Damodar Rai Ramananda, or any devotee like this, always repenting, oh Krishna, then quickly, so quickly, he can come. And he will bound to be controlled and to give darshan. So devotees don't want their darshan, only want to chant in this way. Always. Like, hey Lalite, hey Radhe Lalite, Vraja Devi Kecha Lalite, hey Nanda Suno Kuta, Shri Govardhan Kalpapadapatale Kalindi Vinayita, Goshantavit Sarvatokhedai Mahavivalo Mande. So we are doing Vandana to Jasoda Maiya. A laugh like this, it can bind Krishna. But we want to follow Rup Goswami, like Rup Manjari. We want to be the Hardashana. That more controlled Krishna, more controlled by this way, more than mother. So you should follow Chaitanya Mahaprabhu principles in the line of Swamiji. He has taught you all these things so well. Try to go deep, not outwardly only. I'm thinking that what we are doing outwardly anything, not so deeply. We should try to develop our love and affection, not making high buildings, not making all these things. This should be simple, but our love should be very pure and high class of it. Then Krishna will be controlled with this. Gaur Pramana.
Harina!
Gaur Pramana!
Harina!
Sweet pastimes of Krishna. Especially I wanted to explain the glories of gopis. But I was involved in only Bal Leela Charitra. Only in this, so I could not go up. I wanted. So I want to tell some brief things. After Jashoda Maiya binded Krishna, he became Damodar. But Damodar of Srimati Maiya Jashoda. And after that, in Ras Leela, he became Radha Damodar. All the Sakhi binded Krishna with Srimati Radhika. Then he became Radha Damodar. So after these pastimes of Yashoda Damodar, these pastimes was when Krishna was at the age of 3.5 only. Seeing this, that so many troubles are coming, so many demons are here that try to kill Krishna, but by the mercy of Supreme Personality of Godhead, that is Narayan, or by the mercy of Giriraj Govardhan, Krishna is saved. Kansa also thought that I've sent so many demons, my friends, to kill Krishna, but he could not do it. They could not. Anyone to whom I sent to Braja to kill Krishna, they never returned. Never returned. What happened? So he wanted to go himself there, and himself he wanted to kill Krishna. So he made a plan. He ride on a horse and took his swords. He was so powerful, more than Putana, Agasur, Pakasur and all. He crossed Jamuna River and he has a very beautiful garden there, crossing river Jamuna. And when he reached and he wanted to cross the borderline of Mathura and entering in Gokul, at once he saw a very old lady, very old lady. Hairs all white, white. And his dress was somewhat saffron colors. Her name was Jogmaya, Purnima. He asked and challenged Kans. Kans, where are you going? Where you are going? Stop. And at once he was stopped. He was so powerful, but he could not disobey the order of Yogmaya. Though he was so old, he knew that he is going to kill Krishna. At once, forcibly, he took the hands of Kans and he, in a pond, drowned him. And again, took out. And at once he felt, oh, I am a very old lady, crooked, black, no teeth, so ugly. And no power to also walk. Yogmaya gave him one stick and told him, you should be here. And you should, from today, we will do cow dungs. Cow dungs, man? And he is supposed to be here. And she kicked from his fists or legs. And he went into Braj. And he told that, see how old, ugly, a lady has come from Mathura and I have engaged. And go and see, and if she is not good working, then you should kick her. So all they came, they assembled there, and one by one kicking her, that lady. He wanted to run away from that place, but how to go? He wanted to return to his kingdom Mathura, but he thought that if I am returning there, that anyone will not recognize that I am same Kans, and there also they will kick me. So what to do? So some days he was like this, feeling so much unhappy and ashamed. Then he began to pray, oh Jogmaya, you should come and be very merciful to me. I will never in future come and try to kill him, Krishna. happens, Yogamaya came. And again he drowned in that pond and quickly took off and then he became Kans and quickly he ran away to his kingdom. So he never came in future to Braja to do any harm to Krishna. But he was sending. After this, all the Brajavasis thought that so many disturbances are coming here, problems are coming. And there now no grass for cows to graze. So we should give up this place and we should go to any better place where there are grasses and our cows can graze. And this would be a very best place. And they selected Vrindavan. And then they come. Here Krishna began to graze little calves. And one day he was grazing, at once a Bakasu means a demon in the shape of crane. And Krishna, he wanted to take Krishna in his stomach. But Krishna became like a gola,
fireball,
like a iron ball, so burning and rages. At once he, and then he began to like this. But Krishna quickly took his two, one from and other and in two pieces. Krishna, that I was playing with you, you are also playing with me. But if you are dying, what should I do? But he gave him liberation. Anyhow. After that, Agasu sent any demon named Agasu. Agasu means, Ag means Pap. So many sins like if I had murdered Gurudev, father, mother, like these sins. He was embodiment of all kinds of sin in this world. He came to kill Krishna. But he could not. He swallowed all the cowherd boys and cops, everyone. But he was waiting for Krishna. Krishna quickly came and he went also inside. And when Krishna came inside, he at once closed his mouth. But again Krishna came here. No air here and to pass. Everything was blocked. His eyes also came out. And at once this was cracked. And his soul came out and wandering in the sky. But when Krishna, by his sight, like nectar, he saw all the cowherd boy and cows, they at once in life. All they came out of smoke. And then the light which was in the sky gradually came and entered in the Lord's feet of Krishna. Brahma was looking this. Oh, very big sannyasis and yogi doing so much hard austerities. It is very rare that they have the same destination. But how he quickly achieved so high class of liberation? He wanted to see some more pastimes of his Prabhu. And he wanted to stroll away the cowherd boys and cops and to see another, what he does. And he quickly arranged what happened in the meantime, that all the mothers of Braja, all the mothers of whole Braja, they used to love Krishna more than their sons, and thinking that Krishna should be our son, so that we can take Krishna in our laps and always giving milk, always supporting and nursing Krishna, loving with so affection. They want it. Also, all the now girls of Braja, they have become like 7, 8. They have some intelligence also. So they wanted that, oh, Krishna should be our beloved, our husband. All the cows in Braj, lakhs and crores of cows, they wanted to love Krishna like their children's calves. So what happened? Jogmaya at once dragged Brahma and she showed Krishna these pastimes of Aghasur murder, killing. So actually Jogmaya inspired Brahma to stole away the cowherd boys and calves when they were taking prasadam anywhere in Bhandirban, in Bhandirbat, in the place. And they were playing themselves. Krishna sat in the middle and lakhs of cowherd boys surrounding Krishna were sitting there. One round, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, thousands of around him was there. But all who were back of Krishna, they are thinking that we are in front of Krishna. Those who were far, far away, they were thinking that Krishna, I am with Krishna. And they are giving something to him, taking something. In the meantime, cows were some far, different. They grazing and grazing, they become of some distance. So Brahma had a chance to talk away and stole away. Also, when Krishna and our brother, the cowherd boy, were searching their cows, their calves, in the meantime, Brahma took away all the cowherd boys and kept in a
cave.
Krishna was thinking that where my calves has gone, where my friends are there. At once he knew, oh, what happened? And then he became all the cowherd boy. He became all the calves. And he became all the bansuri, clubs of all goats. Sticks, their kambalia. Kambalia, you know?
This is
Kambal, blankets, and everything Krishna became. The boys, the cowherd boys, their voices, tone of speaking, their mood of walking, everything became like that. And Krishna used to take them and daily going to their homes and coming again in grazing and doing. He did like 1 year. And in this period, Gargachar told that this year is so auspicious. If anyone be married to in this year, they'll be happy forever. Anyone will not be a widow. And the boys will be also so happy. So you should try to marry. If anyone has any child in their homes, they should also be married. Anyhow. How can we married? Oh, they promised to each other, father and mother, that if there will be a son and my will be daughter, then we will marry. Or if you have daughter, I have son, then we should also marry. Like this. So all the girls were married. To whom they are married? Because Krishna was himself cowherd boy, so all marriage was done to. So all the gopis are the wives of Krishna. But in that shape, not in Krishna shape, but in shape of
cowherd boy.
Cowherd. Anyhow, it be. Achinta ghatat ghatpati yasi. Anyhow, they will do. Jogma is so expert and so powerful. So, Krishna became the son of all the gopis. And Krishna became the calf of all the cows. And he became husband of all the gopis. And the purpose was served. After a year, when Brahma returned, he was in confusion that Krishna is playing even with his cops and cowherd boy. But I kept there. I should go and see. And he went and saw that all are there, sleeping. And when he looked here, he saw that Krishna is playing with all. So Krishna is so perhaps powerful. Both time. When I am going to there, to them, and Krishna is taking all the boils and coughs here, and when I am going there, he takes them. But for four eyes here and four eyes here, when he saw that, oh, in both places, how it be? Then he surrendered himself in the lotus feet of Krishna. He saw that everywhere 400 Narayan was there. Everywhere. And then he thought, oh, he is my worshipful deity, Brahma. He is my Aradhade. And then he fell flat. And when he saw towards Krishna, he saw that again Krishna taking rice in his hand and with floating and searching again. Where my cowherd has gone, my friend has gone, where my cops has gone, like this. Brahma knew that, oh, he is Ishwar of Ishwar, Ishwara Sarva Krishna, Ishwara Parama Krishna Sachidana, Sarvakarna. He realized that he is even more than Narayan. Narayan is part and some part of manifestation of Krishna. Krishna is Swayam Supreme Personality. And all are some what? Incarnations, expansions of Krishna. Then he realized the truth. And he prays that I want to be a dust in Vrindavan, or even a stone in Vrindavan, where those who are called Jamadarni in India, sweepers. Even after their job, when they will return to their home, I will be a stone piece there, and with water they will wash their feet on a stone. I want to be even at that stone. I am not so lucky to be anything in Vrindavan, even a grass. But I want the mercy of all the gods. Anywhere I want to take a birth, so that I should be a sprinkled mercy of devotees, true devotees. So much he has prayed. After this, Krishna and Baldev went to Madhuban to graze cows, and after that they came to Madhuban or Talwan, where the trees of palm tree was there so much, lakhs and lakhs. All the birds wanted to take some juice of palm fruit, because at that time there was ripen. So very beautiful smell was coming, very
sweet fragrance.
Baldev went there and he took a tree in his hand and he did like this, and so many fruits came. At once the donkeys came and they attacked Krishna and Baldev and all the boys' friends, but quickly they were all killed by Krishna and Baldev. So who are donkey? Those who try to serve a king like Kans, their friends all are donkey, those who have no relation with Krishna and not serving Krishna. So those who are not really devotees of Krishna, they are like donkeys. They have no intelligence to see that how we can be happy forever. So all are donkey. They want to taste this worldly desires, sense gratifications. All are like demon, like this donkey. So Gurudev Baldev Prabhu is wholesale guru and he killed that donkey. After that, they controlled Kaliya. They controlled Pralambasu, they killed Pralambasu. And so many things they did. Indra was also controlled. He has a false ego that I am creator of this world, I am supporter of this world. So Krishna wanted to teach a good lesson. So he told all the Prajavasi, don't worship Indra. Indra is not a supreme personality. He cannot do anything. He is like a servant of Krishna, but he has a false ego. You should worship Giriraj Govardhan. He can fulfill everything. He is Govardhan. By serving Giriraj Govardhan or Kai, cows, gopi, gobas, everything will be so happy. Nanda Baba did so, and after Indra became so angry, and he wanted to punish all the gopis and Krishna also, but he was punished. I have told all these things yesterday. So it shows that any demigoddesses, even Brahma, Shankar, Mahesh and all, what to speak of Durga, Kali, Ganesh, Shankar or him, they are not supreme personality of God, even not Godhead. Only their God and gods, only the servants of Krishna. Not even to Krishna, to Khirodasai Vishnu or Garbhodasai, like that. They are like God in this world, like Chaukidar.
Watchman.
Having no power at all. But we should try to respect them, not thinking that they are like God. In India, so many persons, they think that Ganesh, Shankar, Hanuman, Kali, Durga, and all the goddesses are same like Krishna. No difference between Krishna and them. But this is wrong thing. We should not try to. Otherwise, it will be a very big offense. We should try to know that Krishna is supreme personality of Godhead. And without his mercy, anything, anyone cannot do. So we should try to worship him, to chant and remember. Best is thing that chant always, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare. But you should try to give honor even to a grass, because Krishna is there in a free autumn seas. So people, but not considering him that he is God. We are not God. We are not Brahman or Brahman. After that, Ras was done, Ras Leela. Very beautiful. For one day of Brahma, lakhs years continuing on, But everyone thought that, oh, this is only 12 hours night. Very quickly passed. After that, consent accrued. You should go to Braja, and at that time Krishna was in Nandagaon. Go, and anyhow, by crook or you should bring Krishna and Baldev. And here when we come, we all friends, like Mushtik, Charun, and my all brothers, myself, and so many are here. We will crush Krishna and Baldev here. He cannot be saved. So anyhow, you should tell them that it's very a sacrifice, fire sacrifice or anything, festival is going there, and you should come, invite them. Akrur went and brought Krishna and Baldev there. And Kansa was anyhow there, was killed. When there was a big council, Krishna and Baldev came in the council. There was a big arena, where all the Pahalwan wrestlers were wrestling together. When Krishna and Balram came there, Krishna and Baldev were like very smooth, very sweet. A boy of only 10 years age or 9 years age. And very delicate. When they came, at one Charan Mushtik, like Himalayan mountain, so big, big chance. They invited Krishna, oh, you should come, and we will wrestle, and we will please our Maharaj Kansa. Krishna and Baldev told and said that we are very little child, so we can wrestle with any boy which are in our age, equal age, equal weight. In our group we can, but not you. You are so big, like so much gents. But they told that you are not a baby. We know that you have killed Putana, Agasur, Bagasur, always playing here, there, jumping, always wrestling to Siddham, Subal, Sakha and all others. We know all these things. So, we know you. And they dragged him arena. And they began to wrestle with them. At that time, Nanda Baba was there. Also, Kans wanted to show Devaki and Vasudev and Ugrasen Maharaj that how I am killing Krishna and Baldev, you should see. In your presence I will kill Kans and Krishna and Baldev. So he has invited all. He has invited all the good persons, rich persons there, to there, to see that festival. So all were there. All the wives of Jadav, newly married or married, were there also. So they were also seeing this scene. They were telling to each other, ladies, that we should not stay here. Kansa is so bad person. He wants to kill Krishna and Baldev. That is, he has engaged Charun and Mushtik and so many demons here. And if Krishna is wrestling here with Charun and Mushtik, we should at once give up this place, otherwise sin will come to us. So anyone should not be there where demons wants to kill any sadhu. they have made a plan like so, and they are doing so nonsense here. So we should quit this place. Oh, we see that in Vrindavan, all the gopis are so
fortunate
that they see Krishna in his usual form, natural form. And here we are seeing Krishna. We are lucky somewhat to see Krishna here, but here not natural Krishna. He is now wrestling with these demons. Sometimes being some anger, eyes are being reddish like. And other party trying to smash Krishna. So we are unlucky. And they are telling to each other, Punyavata Brajabhuvo Jadayan Nilinga Guda Purana Purusha Banachitra Malla Gapalayan Sahabala Kadayan Shavedum Bikridyan Chatigiritra Namachitangrin. Oh, the Braj Gopi are so fortunate. In whole world, Brajmandal is so glorious. So glorious. Why? Because Supreme Personality of Godhead taking his all opulence with adorned with his all madhuris.
Sweetness.
He had descended to Vrindavan. So Vrindavan is so glorious. Especially the gopis are there, so Vrindavan is glorious. If gopis are not there, Vrindavan is not glorious. If gopis are not in Vrindavan with Krishna, then Krishna will be only Brahman like zero. Sundar. So due to gopis, Krishna is so, so lovely. And all kinds of, four kinds of madhurya are in Krishna. So Vrindavan is so glorious. Gopis are so glorious. When Krishna begins to go in his cowherds with lakhs and lakhs girlfriends, with lakhs and lakhs cows, playing his own foot, with Baladev and so many boys, searching anywhere from his crooked eyes, and so many gopis worshipping Krishna with their eyes, lovely eyes. Then Krishna smiles. Those who have seen this Krishna doing so, they are lucky. And their eyes are successful. Those who have not seen Krishna, not taken darshan of this Krishna, in this way, how beautiful he is. Varaha pidam nata varabhapu karnayo karnikar vibhradabhasah kanaka kapishang vejayanti chamal randhran venuradhar sudhaya purayan gopa brindai vrindarannam sabadarbanam pravishatakitakirti. As if whole beauty, whole sweetness, whole sweet fragrance have come in Krishna. And Krishna is like new make clouds, as if water will come. And his clouds are like
thunder, lightning,
so yellow, fragrant yellow. And he had taken float in his mouth. And he is telling something. What telling? Cling. And all are thinking that Krishna is calling me. All the gopis. Deers, cows, calves. Everyone thinking that Krishna is calling me. And all are attracted to Krishna. Varaha pidam natavara bapu. He is like Natavara. What is Natavara? Dancer. But in India, we tell bar to whom? Who is going to?
Bridegroom.
At that time, if a black person, black young person, not so much beauty, but artificially he is made so beautiful by so much giving here, decoration. Powders, decoration, goldly ornaments and everything. And he becomes the prominent in so many persons. So he is called Vara. The Krishna is like so beautiful now. He had not to be decorated. Any, if he is naked, even he is so beautiful. If any spot of black is given here, even he is so beautiful. If he is naked, so more beautiful. We have not to take any help from any ornament, nothing. He is naturally beautiful. And so many cowherd boys surrounding Krishna. Kanhaiya ki jai ho, Kanhaiya ki jai. They are doing like so, glorifying Krishna. And Krishna with his gentle and so soft feet, he is getting his feet on earth, making some impression. Shankha chakra gada padma comes there. So, and gopis are here and there, looking Krishna. And they don't know that what will tell others. And nothing to give their
eyelid.
Palak nahi gire.
Oh,
always like this, they are looking Krishna. So beautiful Krishna there. So they are telling that these gopis are fortunate to see Krishna and to taste his beauty and all kinds of sweetness in full. But we cannot do like this. Even when Krishna supporting cows, grazing cows with Baldev Prabhu and so many cowherd boys, playing on flute, Brahma, Shankar, Lakshmi worship the Lord's feet of Krishna. So see, he is how high. Gopyas tapakim acharan jatam usmarupam lavanya sar asmodhananya siddham dirghbhi pivant anusvanubhavam dirapam ekant dham jasasasya. Oh, these gopis, how hard stories they have done. We want to do like same and to see Krishna in Braja. We want to have a birth in gopi womb to see and taste all these glories of Krishna. Lavanya sar asamurtha ananya siddham. No need of any ornament for to increase the Krishna beauty. We sometimes take golden chain here, some iron rings here, some more other thing, but Krishna never. So he is more beautiful than Narayan 100 times, lakh times. He is more beautiful than Ram. He is more beautiful than Dwarkadish because he has no flute. Now he is young, but Krishna in Vrindavan is teenage, very kishore. In Dwarka there will be no gopi, no flute, no not like natural beauty of Krishna there. So they are so fortunate. What they have done, we should try to do like them. Jado hani vahanani mathano upanika prankhankanardo dito okkhan marjanado gayant chainam anurakt dhiyo ashukanta dhanna prajasti avukamaya. Jado hani vahanani mathano upanika. Oh, how glorious are gopis, that they are in their homes sometimes dohane, they are milking cows. But what they are doing? Their mind is not there. They are habituated to do automatically their hands are going and milking out. But their heart is there, where Krishna is there. And they are singing what? Govinda Damo Dharmapada Veti Govinda Damo Dharmapada Veti Govinda Damo Dharmapada Veti Govinda Damo Dharmapada Veti. Some are doing check in the morning or daytime or evening, and they are also doing that. Their hands are accustomed to do like this naturally, nothing to do like this automatically, but their mind and tongues are good. Govinda Damo Dharmapada Veti Govinda Damo. Some are going to make sleep their children's, and they are doing like this. Oh boy, you should sleep, you should. Not telling, clapping like this. Govinda Damo Dharmapada Veti Govinda Damo Dharmapada Veti house jobs, everything, but always remembering. Some are cooking, and in cooking they are doing. Govinda Damo Dharmapada Veti Govinda Damo Dharmapada Veti. All are objects so much that tears come automatically, hearts melting. So all are engaged, whole day and night like this. They are making all their jobs, more than anyone, but always like this. So we'll have to do, to support our children, to do our house jobs, to maintain our life. But try to make something Krishna mood there, then your all activities will be like bhakti. And if you are not doing, your all pious activities also, without Krishna is like zero. If you are serving your father, mother, so much, but not chanting, remember, you will have to go to hell. Because our original father and mother is who? Himself, Krishna. His fathers of fathers of fathers. His sarvakaran karana. So if any man neglecting Krishna, but doing all past activities, everything, but his all activities like zero. And if they are doing all things, brooming, clearing their houses, cooking, supporting children, and everything, but remembering Krishna, like Govinda Damo Dharmapada Veti Govinda Damo, then your life is successful. Money will cannot make you less successful than happy. Never. But if your all the jobs, all the activities, if it is touched with Krishna consciousness, then everything is okay. If something wrong there, it may be not complete, but even no harm, Krishna will make it full. So they are thinking that gopis are so much high class of devotees. We are not like this. We cannot see Krishna in this way. So they are doing like this. Pratah prajat prajata avishatascha sahin gobhishamam kaneto ashani samavenum nirgamya turnam avalapati purupanya pasyanti sasmutmikam sadhyabhulupan. Oh, gopis are how glorious. In the morning, when Krishna going with all cowherd boys and cows or calves, all gopis are assembled near the house of Nanda Bhavan. All are following Krishna. All gopis here and there, from any corner of their houses, some on the roof, some are
windows,
some are in groves, some are very near, some are very far away, no harm. All are charmed and they are looking towards Krishna and worshipping with their eyes. All. And when Krishna returns from cowherd, again like this, they think that if Krishna is not there, they are feeling so much separation, as if they were dying. And when they are thinking that when morning will come, when evening will come, that when will Krishna will return with all cows, all friends, and they were all waiting there. Sometimes it becomes like so, that if any new gopis is married to Nandagaon, and she is quite new, she wants to take darshan of Krishna, but his sasuri, his mother, oh, don't go, other there is a black snake there, and he will bite it. And that poison will never come down, and you will be met for
ever.
So don't go. But she is going himself, herself. His daughters are going. Then that girl, new remarried, tells that, why you are going yourself? Why your all daughters are going? Why all Brajavasi, old or new or young or even boys, all are going to see, and I should not go? I must go anyhow. So he does not
listen.
And disobeys. And he quickly runs. And sees Krishna. Krishna also, oh, he saw that he is so eager to see me and to meet me. He had something to do, and she at once takes a tail of any
cow.
And at once he begins to run and comes to in front of that gopi. And Krishna with his pole only touches and takes her heart in his heart. And quickly she becomes like mad, without mind, without any life, like a statue.